Starting off first with a 1949 Roosevelt dime. We'll look at some other dated dimes here as well. This is a very, very high graded example of the 1949 Roosevelt dime. It is graded at a mint state 67 plus with full bands. That means that the coin is in extremely good condition. The coin grading scale only goes up to 70. This is at a 67 plus. Here's an example of what full bands looks like on the Roosevelt dimes. So they can't be worn down or anything like that. You know, if you have a 1949 silver dime, these are 90% silver, so they're always worth more than 10 cents. But this coin sold for $3,000 because of the high grade, because of its condition. And it has some really unique and nice toning to it as well. Now here's a 1949 S mint mark. So if we look on the reverse of this coin at the bottom, that's where the mint mark will be. Either no mint mark, D mint mark, or S mint marks for certain years of the Roosevelt dimes. Now this coin has a mint error. It has an uncentered broad strike, which we'll see around the rim of the coin. It is graded by PCGS at an AU50, and this dime ended up selling for around $95. So nothing extremely valuable, but it's over a $90 coin. And you know, you're gonna have to pay to get it graded and things like that, so you're not really gonna make a fortune or anything off a $90 coin. So keep that in mind when you are grading coins. Definitely do your research, check out my videos, and see, you know, which coins you should actually get graded. Here's a 1949 D mint mark. So again, if we look on the reverse, we'll see that D mint mark at the bottom. It has some nice toning to it as well, and it has a very high grade of a mint state 68 with full bands. This coin ended up selling for over $4,000, all because of that grade. Grade population is extremely important when, you know, valuing coins, because if there's only one of these 1949 D mint mark Roosevelt dimes at a mint state 68, or if there's only five of them out there at a 68, that's what's going to make it valuable. Supply and demand. If there's thousands of them at a mint state 67, those aren't going to be as valuable. So keep that in mind. It's all about supply and demand. As you can see, in 1949, they made over 26 million of these coins. So they're not rare in terms of how many they actually made. But here's a good example to compare it to. 1949 D, same coin, same mint mark, same year. However, it is graded at a mint state 65 with full bands. So you're talking three grades lower from a 68, and this coin only sold for around $23. The other coin, over $4,000. And that is a big difference in values, just three grades apart. Now keep in mind, some coins can be graded at a mint state 65 and sell for thousands of dollars. But in this case, it's just specific to this coin that it only sold for $23, because there's a lot of this specific coin out there in this condition. Now some coins out there, it's rare to have them at a mint state 65, so it all depends on each specific coin. Now here's a 1949 no mint mark Roosevelt dime, graded by PCGS at a mint state 65. So this coin only sold for around 15 bucks. Again, big difference there in values. Now here's a high graded example of the S mint mark 1949, graded at a mint state 67 plus with full bands, sold for over $3,000 because of its grade slash condition. Now in 1949, for the S mint mark, they produced a little over 13 million of those coins, so a lot less than the no mint mark, right? But still 13 million is a good chunk of coins. Now if we compare that again to a mint state 63, this is the S mint mark from 1949. This coin only sold for around $45. It is in an older annex holder, so you go from, you know, 3200 to you know, 45 bucks. Big difference there, just based on the condition of the coins. Don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you guys in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.